Hi guys, and welcome to my playthrough of The Old Republic. So this is a new character that I started, and I'm going to play through to start to finish. And this is a Jedi Consular. Now I'm playing this on the Harbinger server, so it's a US server, even though I'm Australian. There are no Australian servers for The Old Republic, so we make do with what we've got. This is actually my seventh character. I've got four Imperial and three Republic, all on Harbinger. So you'll notice as I'm going through, there's some things that I've done that have jumped me ahead a little bit. Like you'll see, in about a couple of hours in, I'll send some credits from one of my other accounts to this one. Just makes it a little bit easier in the long run for getting equipment and all that sort of stuff. Also later on, depending on how things go, I shouldn't have to, but I may also be sending across some basic commendations, which there's a little trick that you can use to do that. But right now, I'm going to be quiet so you can watch the cutscene.
Padawan, I heard your shuttle arriving. I am Master Sio Bakarn of the Jedi Council. Welcome to Tython. This is the ancestral home of our order, where the Jedi first came to be, and where our most promising Padawans complete their training.
With respect, Master Sio, I'd rather be training than talking.
Your instructors tell me that even in childhood you had a remarkable connection to the Force. We haven't seen such power in decades. I was hoping your new master would be here. Yuan left her dig site and is returning to Tython specifically to train you.
If Master Yuan's so keen to train me, you'd think she'd show up on time.
A Jedi Master's time is rarely her own. Patience. Recall the Jedi Code. There is no emotion, there is peace. There is no ignorance, there is knowledge. There is no passion, there is serenity. There is no chaos. There is harmony. There is no death. There is the Force. This is... Yuan, I was beginning to worry.
So you've arrived safely, my Padawan. I'm sorry I can't greet you properly, but we already have a crisis on our hands.
I want to know what's happening.
Tython is a treasure trove of ancient Jedi relics. Recently, our researchers uncovered several teaching holograms, but they've not been fully studied. These holograms may be records of the founders of the Jedi Order. They're absolutely irreplaceable. But A large group of Flesh Raiders has begun rampaging through that region. Those priceless holograms are in danger.
Is there a way to protect the holograms?
Someone must slip past the Flesh Raiders to recover these holograms' projectors. I intend this to be the first task of your training.
No, Yuan. You can't risk a Padawan against Flesh Raiders, even for such important artifacts.
A Padawan who was stronger in the Force at 4 years old than I was at 15? Gifted students need greater challenges.
I was hoping you'd treat my abilities with the respect they deserve.
Pride is not a Jedi virtue, Padawan. Nor is overconfidence.
The holograms are in the Gnarls. Be vigilant. That region has dangers of its own. If you encounter any difficulties, contact me on this holocommunicator. When you have the holograms, meet me at the Jedi Temple. We have much to discuss.
Alright, so we're back in control again now, just going through a few of the things that get thrown up. Now I have a custom set up for my tools, so there'll be certain things that, you know, I don't really need all that often, so I'll chuck them across to the left. You'll also notice as well, when I use my my additional powers tool, I'll get all the extra little bits that come up. That's because I've completed other characters. So I get extra boons to endurance and other stats as well that will help me during the game. So I have to apologise right off the bat for the video quality as well. I've been playing around with it and I've gotten it better now, but it means that the first two planets that I'm on are going to be looking this crap. Now, I'm also playing during the Epic XP bonus, which is in the lead up to Knights of the Fallen Empire expansion that's going to come out in October. So you'll notice that I'm only doing class missions, which will make this go a fair bit quicker than what it does before. It also means that you'll see me jump levels really, really quickly. So. You'll also notice as well that I've already got 14 mail items, even though I've only just started this character. That's because I've been a member pretty much on and off since the start, and you get a whole heap of bonuses every time you start your in your account. So there's things like paint jobs for Galactic Starfighter, there's gear from Galactic Starfighter, which actually comes in really handy later on when you start getting modifications and armoring and all that sort of stuff, because it's a ready-made orange set of gear that you can pop all that stuff into. There's a few things, like pets that you can get too. There's these anniversary fireworks that I find a pain in the ass because they just, you know, chog up your inventory. One thing that's really useful that you would have just seen there is the Hutt statue. This is actually a bonus from pre-ordering the Rise of the Hutt Cartel expansion. And it makes it a mobile trainer, so it means that when you go up a level, instead of having to go back to the go back to where your trainer is, you can call the statue out and he's there ready to go. So you see, I just moved him down the bottom and then put him into the hot bar up the top so that I can hold on to him. So I'm just activating everything. See, there's a couple of titles there that I've got already, and a couple of pets. And that's another title, and that's a paint job, so I'm going to whack that down the bottom until I can get to my cargo storage and chuck them out. And then those boxes, one of those is more fireworks, and the others are four sets of orange gear, empty orange gear. But that's good for us because it means that we can use it later on. And that other box as well is also some crystals that will greatly improve, like they're plus one There's four crystals, one's plus one power, one's plus one endurance, one's plus one's critical expertise, and there's a plus one for something, a plus 41 for something else that I can't remember. So, because I'm trying to rush through and do this, I'm going to try and avoid fights as much as I can. Sometimes I'll miss out. Other times that'll happen and it will just, you know, be ridiculously easy. And see another fight happening already, which is annoying. So, one of the good things about the Consular is later on I will get a stealth ability which will make passing these mobs a lot quicker. And let us go through a lot faster. So you can see I'm constantly referring to the map as well to try and work out where everything is. Sometimes I get it wrong. I'm also ignoring those things because they're extra quests, because normally if you don't have the epic XP boost you'll do those and it will increase your level so that you can be the correct level at the right place.
Activation protocol begins. So, after the long silence, finally someone comes. I am Garen Jard. Millennia ago, I stood as a founder of the Jedi Order.
There are flesh raiders in the area. Your holoprojector's at risk. I'm here to save it.
To protect without fighting. A trait I wanted at the core of our beliefs. The Jedi may have changed, but collective peace has always remained one of our goals. Activation protocol complete. Go well.
One of the things that I like to do as well is have sort of an internal monologue for my characters. I'm sure it's something that everybody does at some point too, and that there's a goal that I have. And for this character in particular, I want it to be a dark side character. Mainly because I keep on hoping that BioWare at some point will have an allegiance swapping thing, so I'll be able to move my Consular to the Imperial side.
Activation protocol begins. Ah, another has come to listen. When the Jedi Order was founded, I, Kella Bryn, said we should devote ourselves to justice. True justice cannot be driven by emotion. We Jedi can set our passions aside and seek the truth without fear or favor.
The projector for this hologram is in danger. I'm here to recover it.
Then do what is needed. That too is part of justice. Activation protocol complete.
Yeah. So I'll have an internal story in my head, so trying to make this one dark side, in the vague hopes that we might be able to swap factions later on down the track. So you'll see my Jedi Knight that I have is purely light side, so I've gotten that to level 5 light side. I've got a Sith Inquisitor who's level 5 dark side, which is maximum dark side points. Haven't come across any light or dark side options just yet. And I've also got a Sith Warrior who's purely light side as well.
Activation protocol begins. A new Jedi comes to learn. Excellent. Excellent. I am Ter Sendon, keeper of the histories, a founder and chronicler of the Jedi Order. I saw us becoming guardians of knowledge and secrets. We Jedi would safeguard the wisdom of the galaxy.
I've come to retrieve the projector for your hologram. It's in danger of being destroyed by flesh raiders.
Saving what could be lost forever. My thanks. Activation protocol complete.
My other character, non force using characters, so the trooper, the agent, and the bounty hunter, I sort of kept neutral, or just whatever sort of fit in best. Like my bounty hunter was, you know, an honourable mercenary sort of thing, so he protected who he was with. My imperial agent was really, really loyal to the Imperials.
Master Yuan, I've encountered a problem. One of the holo projectors has been stolen.
Stolen? But the Flesh Raiders don't steal, they destroy. I'll look into this. If you have the other holograms, come and meet me at the Jedi Temple. I'm sending you directions now. And please, Padawan, be careful.
And my Republic Trooper is sort of a little bit on the dark side, but that's because of the nature of the story of the Trooper. To begin with, she's sort of out for revenge, and but then sort of falls into line with protecting the Republic and doing the best things for the Republic. One of the things you'll notice as well is that I've got an ability called Rocket Boost, and this is a very, very handy ability because it lets you move fast, as fast as the top rung speeders, without having to actually be in a vehicle, which is handy in certain areas such as buildings because they don't allow you to use mounts, which does get annoying in the first couple of planets. But as part of the Epic XP bonus as well, they made a change a while back so that as soon as you get to the planet, all taxi points are already unlocked. So you can travel to them as quick as much as you like. You'll also find that quick travel is a lot easier too. So I've unlocked a fair bit in the Cartel market, so I've reduce the cooldowns of a lot of things, so quick travel has a cooldown of 0 for me now, which is absolutely brilliant, love it. And it just means getting around planets is so much easier. Tython's a little bit meh when it comes to travel, just because it's so big and doesn't have that many well-placed quick travel points or taxis as well. So this one, I think, took me like 2 hours to get out of here, which is ridiculous for the first planet. Most other species will just take you 1 hour. And I'm looking at this video thing, it's gone for, you know, 18 minutes already, so we'll finish it off soon. We're going to go to visit this Jedi Council and finish off this, and you'll see I'm at level 2 at the moment, and this you can see my XP down the bottom where it's that little yellow bar just went up a little bit because I discovered a place. But yeah, I'll go in here and you'll see as soon as I finish this I'll be almost level 4. It's a little bit ridiculous sometimes. So after the cutscene up here, I'm going to finish up for this recording.
There isn't. It's out of my hands, Kaizen. I haven't. Padawan, come in. This is Kaizen Fess, an old friend. He's here on a hunting expedition. A sacred Trandoshan tradition.
It's an honor to meet you.
Dornor Basru, the Endectrus, Santalis, Mortav Rapsak.
So Some people, even some Jedi, disapprove of my friendship with Kaizen. I wanted you to meet before rumors prejudiced you. First, thank you for saving the holograms. The Jedi have lost enough lately without losing our history, too.
Loss is a small word for what we suffered at the Empire's hands.
That discussion will have to wait. I've identified the holoprojector that was stolen. It contained a hologram of Master Rajivari. Rajivari was another of the Jedi founders. He turned to the dark side. He betrayed the very order he helped to create.
Why would the founders keep Rajivari's image among them, after what he did?
Excellent question. To honor his previous contributions? Or a gesture of healing? Rajivari was immensely powerful. That stolen hologram could hold his darkest secrets. The thief is likely from Kalikori village. Local Twi'lek pilgrims here illegally. Many of them are poor or hungry.
You said Kalikori village isn't a legal settlement. I didn't think Tython had such laws.
The Republic couldn't give the Twi'leks permission to colonize Tython. Too dangerous. But they came regardless. I'd like you to go to Kalikori village, discover who took the holoprojector and retrieve it. But tread lightly. The Twi'leks are here in defiance of Republic law. We're forbidden to fully defend them, even when the Flesh Raiders attack. Relations are strained.
If the Twi'leks can't survive here without help, they should leave.
Tython is their home, Padawan. They have nowhere else to go. When you reach Kalikori village, find Bashen, captain of the village guard. He knows everyone. He may have seen the holoprojector. I think meeting these pilgrims will be a good lesson for you, Padawan. Go carefully.